What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. I am a master plumber and HVAC contractor in the states of Florida, South Carolina, and New York. And if you got one of these US Boiler Burnham gas steam boilers in your home that's not heating, this video may be for you. All right, so we got a no heat call. We have this Burnham Independence gas steam boiler. You can always tell it's a steam system by the 2-inch piping coming out of the top of the boiler, but also most importantly, if you got a sight glass. So we have a sight glass there, it indicates the water level of the boiler, and we have low water controls such as a low water cutoff, automatic feeder. Now, this light was flickering and I heard the click of the thermostat relay when I tried turning on the light. Let's see if I can get this cover off using two hands. I'm thinking that we got a power problem here. So we have an SIN7. This is a 110,000 BTU input gas fired steam boiler. This is that thermostat relay. We have our connections, our low voltage connections going to this relay. And you should put a zip tie on it to keep it secure. The constant clicking on and off loosens up that connection. And it's an annoying nonsense, no heat call. I am thinking, well, that's that boiler over there. Combustion test that we did in 2022 on November 17th. But I don't have any illumination on my, no, not there, on my low water cutoff. I did get a click there. The damper was open. Interesting. Interesting. That damper is open and it's in the automatic operation. Let's see if I have 24 volts going to my electronic ignition module for intermittent pilot.
All right, I'm going to remove the two wires from the intermittent ignition control. This is going to be 24 volts, and the yellow wire is going to be 24 volt ground. I want to see if we got voltage here. Got my voltmeter. Let's see what we got. I have, looks like 2 volts. Looks like we may have something other than the safety circuit preventing operation, but let me get my alligator clips on my test leads. And yeah, I'm not getting a signal.
Or 24 volts to the intermittent pilot ignition control. I just nudged the automatic vent damper with a needle nose. just to force it to cycle.
Okay,
it's almost open. Once that end switch is closed, we should hear something here, and I don't think we'll have a voltage change there. Interesting. Let's see. I want to kill power to the fan in the can briefly. I think my other boiler is also wired to the fan in the can. I think that's wired to the fan in a can as well. Interesting. That power switch controls that fan in a can by field controls. That allows for combustion air to be brought in to the mechanical room from outside. I've still got my gut feeling something's up with this low water cutoff right here. That's my gut. My gut is telling me something's up with this low water cutoff. So let's bypass that and see if it causes anything. All right, I jumped out the pink and the blue wire. My vent damper opened shortly thereafter, and I have 24 volts going to my Honeywell intermittent pilot ignition control, so we know that's good. We know the pressure control is good. We know the rollout switch is good. The spill switch in the back of the boiler is good. Only thing that's not good is the low water cutoff. And I just proved that by bypassing the pink and the blue wire, bypassing the control, and getting 27 volts to the ignition control module. I need to replace this module. I reconnected the wires to THW and then 24 volt ground. We have our status light. And Houston, we have ignition. So I'm taking out the CycleGuard low water cutoff and putting in the McDonnell Miller, the PSE-802-24. So I gotta replace the probe because the layouts of the screws that secure the device to the probe are wider on the existing, the CycleGuard, and this is narrower. Not as far apart, so I'm not using any Teflon tape on the threads, just the pipe dope. That's what it says in the manual. Don't use PTFE tape. Looks like we're almost below the height of the probe tapping. We'll throw this in there, hook it up, and head off to the next. I've been waiting to use the PSE 802-24 or any other low water cutoff from my truck. Basura. Because now I can stock the 4-in-1 low water cutoff, the FPC-1000 by McDonnell Miller, to replace 4 different low water cutoffs. This 4-in-1 device replaces both 110 and 24 volt low water cutoffs for steam and hydronic systems with manual and auto reset control. I think that's 6 different configurations, right? Wow. 6 low water cutoffs in one box. If you're stocking separate low water cutoffs in your trucks, just do this. One control does it all. McDonnell Miller FPC 1000. It's awesome.